Hello guys, welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk about the movie The King's Speech, and I'm going to discuss some questions related to the movie and give you some recommendations related to the main topic. I hope you're doing great and enjoy our time together. As I already said, I'm going to talk about the movie The King's Speech. So let's start with a quick synopsis of the movie. What is the movie about? First of all, it's a British historical drama film directed by Tom Hooper. The film focuses on the years 1934 to 1939, before the Second World War. The movie is about the England's Prince Albert, which is played by the actor Colin Firth, most ascend the throne as King George VI. But he has a speech impediment. He is a stutterer. Knowing that the country needs her husband to be able to communicate effectively, Elizabeth, which is played by the actress Helena Bonham Carter, hires Lionel Logue, which is played by the actor Geoffrey Rush, an Australian actor and a speech therapist, and to help him overcome his stammer. An extraordinary friendship develops between the two men, as Logue used unconventional means to teach the monarch how to speak with confidence. In the movie, we can see some erroneous vocal recommendations made to the Duke of York. For example, when someone is told him that let the microphone do the work. And another example that we can see in the movie, it's that one of the many therapists he had tells him to put 7 marble in his mouth and try to read something which is almost impossible. Now, what are some vocal and relaxation exercises taught by Lionel, the teacher? Well, in the film, we can see how Lionel teach him certain exercises that help him to improve his diction, such as breathing, which is very important, tongue twisters, relax the jaw, exercise with the mouth, vocalization, hold the vowels in one tone, like, okay, move, sing about many others and some that we have already seen in one of the past videos. Now, what's the name of the disorder of the voice that has the Duke of York? His personal struggle to control his stuttering, or as the king calls, it's stammering. Okay, what is this disorder? Well, let's make a quick summary of this disorder, that stuttering. The stuttering, also known as stammering and dysphonia, is a speech disorder in which the flow of a speech is disrupted by involuntary repetitions and prolongations of sounds, syllables, words or phrases, as well as involuntary silent pauses or blocks in which the person who stutters is unable to produce sounds. In the movie, we can see that Lionel have other job besides helping people with their voices disorders. In a part of the movie, we see how Lionel is talking to Bertie, and he says that he act bit, reside in pubs, and told elocution in schools as well. Let's see some recommendations to someone that needs to read a speech in public?
First of all, ask ourselves if, are my words familiar ones? Are my key ideas worked as strictly as possible? And then, do I have a properly prepared manuscript to memorize and rehearse? Am I completely familiar with the basic structure and materials of my speech? Second, write the speech in a way that is natural for your style of speaking. 3. When it comes to giving a speech, speaking without notes is best and speaking with sunset. Focused notes is next best. 4. Before starting any speech, relax, breathe deeply, and if necessary, do some exercise that will help you speak better, such as tongue twister or vocalization. 5. Maintain close control over the tone or the timing of your speech, or both, and have fun, let nerves go.
Some of the speeches that the Duke of York read on the movie, they were very interesting, as for the example, the one that says, to be or not to be, one of the most famous fragments of William Shakespeare. And so each of the speeches that he reads and with difficulty, but help him to improve better his diction. Something that caught my attention, it was that the king's speech is based on the true story of Queen Elizabeth II's father and his friendship with his unorthodox speech therapist Lionel Logue. As the second son of George V, Bertie was not expected to ascend to the throne. But when his brother Edward abdicated to marry American Wallis Simpson, Bertie was crowned King George VI. 9 weeks before filming began, the production team discovered that Lionel Logue had a grandson living in London who still had Logue's paper, including a diary detailing his working relationship with the king. The script was immediately rewritten and filming took place in various locations in England, including Regent's Park, Ely Cathedral, Harley Street, and Battersea Power Station. My favorite speech that moved me deep down was the last speech in the final movie that said,
in this great power, perhaps the most faithful in our history, I send to every household of my peoples, both at home and overseas, this message, spoken with the same deep of feeling for each one of you, as if I were able to cross your threshold and speak to you myself for the second time in the lives of most of us. We are at that war. Over and over again, we have tried to find a peaceful the way out of the differences between ourselves and those who are now our enemies, but it has been in vain. We have been forced into a conflict, for we are called but to meet the challenge of a principle which, if it were to prevail, would be fatal to any civilized order in the world. Such a principle stripped of all disguise, as surely the mere primitive doctrine that might is right for the sake of all, that we ourselves hold dear it. It's unthinkable that we should with use to meet the challenge. It is to this I propose that I now call my people at home and my peoples across the seas who will make our cause their own. I ask them to stand calm and firm and united. In this time of time, the task will be hard. There may be dark days ahead, and war can no longer be confined to the battlefield, but we can only do the light as we see the right, and reverently commit our cause to God. If one and all we keep resolutely faithful to it, then with God's help, we shall prevail.
So, why do I think it's such a good speech? Because this last speech, apart from encouraging his people to be prepared about the war to come and giving them encouragements to be calm, is his first speech in which he shows everyone that he can speak without stuttering, and that he is going to be a better king who effort every day to improve better. And well, that it was for today. Thank you very much for being here, and see you next time. Bye-bye.